Welcome back and hello if you're new. So this week we're going to be returning 10 years into what was 2008, which you could argue was the heyday for the deathcore genre. Now the headliners of tours the likes of Never Say Die and with a brand new album in the works, it all really started off with their second album, This Is Exile, in 2008. One of the most potent records to be released in 2008, and it would be the beginning of one hell of a career. But what Whitechapel were always characterized by, for me personally, was the three guitar onslaught. Combining the use of three guitarists, not only were the band able to create an incredibly heavy sound when needed, but most importantly, were able to create this atmospheric layering and a sense of texture in an otherwise fairly one-dimensional genre. For example, there are some absolutely killer melodies here. In both the beginning and the end of Father of Lies. The title track, This Is Exile, almost reminds me of a kind of Trigger the Bloodshed style riff. But similarly, the band were able to also riff just like mad, and it reminded me somewhat of At the Gates, for example, In Possession. And also in Somatically Incorrect. And not to mention that To All That Are Dead have got this really kind of malevolent atmosphere. Similar to the likes of, you know, Through the Eyes of the Dead, and all of these bands are all sprouting up at the same time, including Redcord, you could argue, whose very own Guy Kozlowicz, I can never pronounce his name, the lead singer of Redcord, features on Exalt. The stipulation is obvious. They'll be forming outrageous. But when the band want to go heavy, there are some absolutely anvil heavy breakdowns that the band put together. For example, on Father of Lies, stand your fucking ground. Or for example, in This Is Exile with that classic, this world is, you know, breakdowns were characteristic of the genre, but no one seemed to do them as well as Whitechapel. Just as much as the band were able to really crush with that heavy sound, there are also some amazing groove sections. The opening and final sections of Possession really get you kind of like nodding your head. Exalt as well, as I mentioned. One thing I always thought that This Is Exile created was a real sense of atmosphere, which usually came at the end of the tracks, but it was a really nice way to kind of segue into the next section. For example, Death Becomes Him. And again, of Legions as well, the instrumental on the album is incredibly intricate, but it's very well thought out, and you could see that this is where Whitechapel were beginning to, you know, have ideas that were somewhat above their station. Drums also, there are some absolutely fantastic blasts on the title track, This Is Exile. And one of my favourites has always been the dynamics that Whitechapel have put together. So for example, in To All That Are Dead, there's that sort of slide section where they go from a Cannibal Corpse riff into this massive groove. But it was interesting to see that the band would go on to create this evolution, which brings me to my final point, which is Messiahbolical. The 7.5 minute track really showcased that the band aren't just content with having breakdown after breakdown, and there's actually a lot of progression going on in this music, which would lead to A New Era of Corruption, the self-titled record Our Endless War, and most recently, Mark of the Blade. And I feel that that is one of the reasons that the band were able to kind of transcend this casual deathcore tag to where they are now headlining massive stages. Whitechapel were one of the flag bearers of the death metal, deathcore, whatever you want to call it, movement. Arriving at the same time as the likes of the Black Dahlia Murder, All Shall Perish, The Acacia Strain, Carnifex, Job for a Cowboy, Red Chord, The Red Shore, Suicide Silence, all of these bands were at the height of popularity in 2008. This record shows a band that were fearlessly creative and had big ideas that were well above their station. Despite probably their most significant paradigm shift in sound, that would be the self-titled record, it would have never really happened had This Is Exile not been there in the first place. I've seen that Whitechapel have been in the studio with Mark Lewis. I would imagine that there's some new material on the horizons, so we'll keep our fingers crossed. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, hit that like and subscribe button. Also make sure to check out my own channel, The Metal Tris. I've got reviews, interviews, all sorts of stuff. Thank you so much for Metal Sucks for this collaboration as ever. What did you think of This Is Exile? Comment in the sections down below. I'll try and reply to as many as I can. And I'll see you next week for another Apocalyptic Anniversaries. Alright guys, see you later.